What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to give you the exact defensive strats I use in solo queue to get high plat every single season. Now, I want to start off by saying, disclaimer, these are tactics that I use while solo queuing and strats that I find successful in doing so. I find my most success in playing aggressive and having decent aim in solo queue. These strats will kind of reflect that. These strats are also just to give you an idea of what you should be trying to execute while playing solo queue on certain maps and bomb sites. And if you can't already tell, we're going to go ahead and jump into it today on one of my favorite maps, Border, and the most popular site for defense, Lockers and Archives. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and go over reinforcements, spawn peaks, certain ways and certain rooms that you should be trying to defend. I'll even go over barbed wire locations, Valk cams, and then just kind of good overall spots to hold down. So let's jump into it right with the reinforcements. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm just going to come right over here and I'm just going to shoot where I believe all of the reinforcements should be. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and then you have one more. So you could go either at this wall or you could go one of these two other walls in Fountain. Now, in solo queue, 9 times out of 10, you can guarantee that these two walls and then these front two walls will be reinforced. I will definitely say the two walls that I would focus on is I would get this wall, and the reason for this is because of the angles that the attackers can create whenever they attack from the locker side. So I'll just make a little hole there. So you'll see this commonly, but you're holding an angle all the way down to any rotates through the site. So if they're able to clear out the rest of the site, like behind half wall or nade them out or something else, they're able to hold an angle on anyone who tries to rotate into A. So that's easy picks for them. The other reason why I would say hold the one down here is for that exact same reason. So if they are to create, we'll just say like a decent sized hole right here, they can sit all the way back here and then just hold a tight angle on anyone who rotates and have a clear shot at them. So reinforcing these two walls and reinforcing that wall definitely helps with some of those rotations. So depending on where you're holding in sight, you can definitely hold the site a little bit better without giving them those peaks. If you wanted to use your 10th one, if you want to hold specifically in this closet with like a mirror or something, I would probably recommend doing the hatch as well, so a buck or someone else doesn't come below you and able to take out your mirror with ease, or shoot you in the back or something like that. So next we'll go over some of my favorite spawn peaks. Alright, so on this site, generally whenever I start on defense, I definitely like to do this spawn peek over into the valley. So basically what you end up seeing is they will spawn, I'll kind of show you, they'll spawn about right up there, and a lot of people will hug this wall all the way down. So they get cover between the palm trees, but if you're holding this angle, you really want to look for them right in between these posts is when you'll start noticing people. They'll come around that wall pretty quick while sprinting. So if you kind of hold an angle with this wall so no one over here can get a counter peek on you, you're able to see them pretty easily and get them in between these. So that's an easy spawn peek, and it's pretty hard to counter. Especially, I see it mostly countered in higher plat. Most of the time in gold, silver, most people don't even see that as a spawn peek, and it's almost never used. Another one that I really like, I think I saw this, someone else posted this, I think on the subreddit or something else, but holding an angle right here, you can make a punch hole, or you can make a single shot hole if you have an ACOG. Holding this angle is really strong as well. You can make punch holes above and then shoot down here, so then they spray up there and miss it. If you want to know how to line this up really easily, go ahead and just make a mark right in the center and line up with that, and you will put those shots right at where they come around that corner. Another one is, of course, most people will know about this one as well, this east stairs run out. This one is super good for catching people off guard. For some reason, especially since the claymores disappeared, this one became really popular again. So because people weren't able to put claymores on this little corner right here, it was pretty easy. And I like this run out because even if you tear down the barricade, you have all this protection right here to run fully out if you want to. Or you can even use it, pier this corner right here, and all this other stuff. So this one is a really good run out. We'll go ahead and go over just a couple more here. And then I'll go over some barbed wires and valk spots. So one run out that a lot of people don't suspect, this is one that I actually use in plat a lot, is run out here and then looking down this way. So obviously, as you can see, I'm detected by the time I round the corner. And you do have to kind of be, it's a little risky with people right here, but in my experience, I haven't had too many people actually shoot me in the back. So if you kind of just get your going and then you use this wall as defense from behind, you can shoot them right here. Don't expect it, run back, and then most of the time you're able to get away with ease. And then finally, the last run out is you can run out of either this door or this one over here, but looking at this balcony, looking right about here is pretty good. And then I'll go ahead and do one more that I almost never see anyone peek from, but I do it all the time and I get free kills from it. So we'll run down here real quick. And this is one, like I said, like nobody uses this for whatever reason. I don't know if it's just not popular or what, but let's go ahead and popularize this. Peeking right here, get that out of the way. You can actually hold an angle all the way down to there. So anyone who tries to dodge this peek from here and go around this truck basically run right into your gunfire. It's one that is because this area is so dark, you're able just to hold this with an ACOG is what I find easiest, but you can just spray people down and mow them down. And you have plenty of time here, even though it's not a pixel, but it's pretty close. So that one's a really good one as well. So next we'll go ahead and we'll go over some barbed wire spots. Depending on the character, since I made this for solo queue, my idea is you watch this video, you see what I do to be successful, you implement some of those things. So I know a lot of people don't reinforce this 90 hallway here, so I want to see this more and just kind of get the word out about some of these things. So if you're someone who plays more on-site characters who have barbed wire, someone else, these spots will be for you if you don't really know where to put it or you want to put in the most effective spots. So definitely the first one is in metal here. And beepers, I think, is what a lot of people call it. So right here, this will slow down people who are trying to jump through this window, unless you board it up, or just trying to run into sight in general. So that's a really powerful one. Another one that I see a lot of people actually mess up is you want to put one at this door, but you want to put it just a little bit back more. So what you do is if you place it back, they'll have to come in to swipe at it. But if they try to run in, and even if they try to run around it, they'll still get hit by it. So even putting it more at like diagonal, like right here, you really want to make them work for it, but be impactful at the same time. Whether they waste utility on it or not, that's just another good one. So placing that farther back from the doorway is also really good. A third spot that I really enjoy is right in between this doorway. This is one that you can just place right here. And then if you wanted to, if you have another one, right at this doorway as well. That just makes it to where these doorways and everything else are at least blocked, and you'll know if someone's destroying it or something. So next we'll go over some valk cam spots. So my number one that I throw every single time is the one up here. Almost no one ever goes on the roofs or anything, so this cam is almost always able to stay up. It's pretty hard to see, nobody really looks this high. This is basically just a free office cam. You can see into fountains as well, so you can watch for those rotates or you can have your teammates watch for it. And like I said, that's one that normally stays up all game. It's really nice. Another one that I throw almost every time, this one I actually got from Coconut Bra. So I'll definitely give credit where credit is due, but right under there, you throw that there. Even standing from this door, you can't tell, but with this cam, you have visibility over this entire site. So that's, you cannot see that cam. If you didn't see how I threw that, I like to explain how I kind of throw it, but if you aim just a little bit higher than this drain, like right there, it's perfect every single time. Perfect cam. My third one is kind of just random. Sorry, had a cut there, but the last one that I like to throw is somewhere here in CCTV. A lot of times I just try to blend it in with the TVs. They're not perfect spots by any means, but they'll at least get the job done a little bit. So you can kind of create your own spots here. CCTV is another strong place to put a cam. Maybe even putting it like in between the TVs, I think I've done a couple times. I kind of experiment in here. I don't really have a go-to spot, but that's where I try to throw my third one for at least a little bit more intel. And then finally, we will go ahead and go over spots that typically are ones that you want to hold. So depending on your playstyle and your aim and everything else, like I said, I like to play aggressive, so I will roam, but I'll also even play on site. So a lot of times I'll try and peek, especially if I play someone with a ACOG. I'll try and do a spawn peek and get that free pick right off the bat, especially if it's the first round. So holding half wall here is a really good one. If you have a bandit, or if you are a bandit, and you can bandit trick this wall as much as possible and just stop them from taking it, and then holding this half wall door, you're really able to, like, control basically the all of A site just from that one spot. So that spot is really strong. If you end up reinforcing this wall, you can actually hear if they're planting or something, so being able to turn around this corner and shoot, you'll be able to put bullets basically right into that corner. As you can see, I shot, like, right through the window. So, even if they come in right here, you'll be able to at least hit them, or you can see them. So, that's normally a spot for someone with a shotgun. Maybe smoke or someone like that. Another good spot to hold is actually just in between sandwich here for lockers. And kind of switching between these two spots depending on where you're needed. The reason why this spot is really good is this is another... It's not a spawn peak, so I didn't include it in that section, but it's another spot. So, actually, you can watch people as they climb up to vents here. With this little pixel peek, and they can't see you whenever they climb up this ladder, but you can see them as they climb up from the bus to the vents here, so you can sit right here and put shots all right down there. So that's another good spot to hold. This is somewhere where you can rotate if you're even holding half wall, or if you sit here first to watch for vents, then move to half wall. So these two spots are really strong. Another one that everyone seems to know about, but no one seems to use, is the spot up here. So this spot, I don't know, every time I use it, I just have pretty good success with it. So you're able to watch a deep angle into anyone who rotates into here. And another way that you can use that is you can actually watch, I'll show you with a cam here. We'll throw this up here. So you can sit there, watch that spot, and if you didn't see how I got up there, you need this computer. You look at the corner basically right here, and it'll launch you right up, so you'll have no problem. So you can kind of sit here and watch that doorway, and then you can peek. Even from this spot, you basically won't be seen, so you're good. And then you can peek this window right there, and you're also able to sit up here, and then you can watch anyone who attacks from here. Most of the time, whenever people are entering from here, they're looking right here, they're looking at the door, they don't look up there. It's just this is the way it is. I'll go ahead and do two more spots. We'll do two more. So holding here in offices is really good. This is normally where I rotate later in the round, so I'll kind of roam off site, see if I can get some easy peeks on a buck or someone else trying to push. Sit here in office and hold this. Finally, the last spot. This is definitely a high traffic area, but if you're someone like a vigil or someone with impacts, and you can hold down CCTV, you can blow this hatch or this hatch. And you can sit here and hold these three entryways as much as possible. And then if you get overran, you can just jump down the hatches. This is one that'll kill a lot of defenders time, which in solo queue is really good because most of the time teams aren't coordinated enough. So you're able to just do your thing and hang out and get that all done. So I think that basically wraps it up for what I typically do. Like I said, I roam and then I'll come to those major spots. I reinforce 90 or I'll reinforce that office area. Place the barbed wire if I have it, and just basically go for aggressive peaks and go from there. So whenever we meet back, we'll go ahead and we'll move on to vents and workshop, what I believe to be the second most popular bomb site on this map. So I'll see you then. All right, what's up? We're back in the server vents, whatever you want to call this, in workshop area. So real quick, we'll go over which walls to reinforce. We'll kind of go through the same rotation. We'll look at spawn peaks, what to defend, barbed wire. I can go over a couple of out spots, but we'll just go ahead and do this. So first off on this site, you want to make sure you have someone that can make a rotate hole here. This is going to be pretty standard stuff. Most people know about this. Getting into this bomb site with this locker here is really powerful, so you can watch this window. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to reinforce this wall. This is going to stop. This is going to allow you to kind of rotate here freely without getting lit up from someone from the window. So if this wasn't reinforced, this window guy has basically a clear shot if you try to rotate around this corner. If you don't know what to do with your last reinforcement, this wall is fine as well. You can do both of them. Not a bad idea, but not necessary. So just this one wall. Next, you want to make sure you get both the hatches. So this hatch and this hatch. I find in solo queue, if you give up those hatches, unless you're with a coordinated team and you're going to hold upstairs, it's better just to reinforce it and force the defenders to either not have their Habana or Thermite die, or bring those hard breachers in general. Typically, even if I hold up there, I'll go ahead and reinforce those, and then I'll open up like different hatches or something like that. Next, you want to make sure this wall, this is a very important one because it goes straight through, all the way through to tellers. So you want to make sure that you make sure to reinforce this, otherwise they can sit at that window and basically have a clear shot into workshop. And then I would go ahead and do these three walls, just reinforce all the bathroom. You'll have three more after that to give you a total of 10, and you can just do these three. So that's one, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All 10. Next, we'll go over some spawn peaks. I'll keep the same front spawn peak that's over here. So I'll go into that window and looking at that bus. Another really powerful one. Another one that I don't think I've ever been killed by, but I kill people all the time through, is actually sitting here with almost any gun you want and actually just watching down these stairs. So a lot of people to dodge this spawn peak. So actually, if you do this spawn peak and kill someone, you can come down here the next round and kill them again right here. Typically, people will try and avoid those spawn peaks. So, and the last one that I'll go over is more of a run-out spawn peak, but it's over here in detention. I think I should at least talk about it. This one is really strong. This is something that I'll try and do on first round, maybe. You run all the way out here, basically have free reign in their spawn. That one is really strong as well. Like I said, normally if you get away, you can only get away with that for one round. So switch up your spawn peaks. Be aggressive though. I think spawn peeking is the best way that a defender can set themselves up to win the round. So I highly recommend it. Next, we'll go over what to defend. So if you're playing on site, I highly recommend sitting behind here, behind this little bookshelf. You can watch this. You're able to watch doorway. You can kind of be seen from this hatch, but you can also, like, kind of hold a pixel right here and then not be seen from that hatch. And then that hatch is pretty hard to see you as well, just because of the angle that that hatch is at. So this is a pretty good spot for seeing if anyone goes in there. Another good spot that a lot of people may know about, but sitting right here in this corner, you can watch this hatch really easily. You're also able to watch main lobby here and going onto those east stairs. So this is a good for like a dog or someone. I recommend destroying the TVs just because once they fall down, you have a little bit clearer. So holding this is a really strong one. As for on-site, sitting back here is really good. I really don't recommend sitting on B unless you play someone with maybe like a shotgun and you want to play aggressive at the window or something like that. There's not really too many spots. You can't really get behind the corner here, so you're kind of just in a stuck. So I don't really recommend that. I will go over some barbed wire, though. So some really good spots is putting one here, putting one here, putting one right here. The reason for this one is it stops anyone coming in from the door, but also a lot of people who drop from this hatch will drop and then they'll land right here. So if they're slowed down, that one really helps. Putting one at the window stops anyone from jumping in through the window. Putting one right here in between this door. This can alert you if you're a doc or someone right here. So you can kind of just peer through right there. And then the last one is you can put it right here, right at this doorway. Next, we'll go over some Valk Cam spots. So like I said, this site isn't super good for it, but you can definitely still get away with it. Valk just is like the easiest person to give intel, so that's why I recommend her, especially on this map. It's really easy. So definitely putting one up in this corner. You can watch anyone who comes in. I would recommend probably the same thing right here, putting one in this far corner. And then really the last one I would do is you can do multiple runouts or throwouts for Valk, but I would recommend trying to get it up on this light pole or somewhere else. There's many throws. You can look up videos on how to throw them up there, but that's basically it for the Valk spots. Like I said, they're not super good. Another spot, if you don't want to reinforce, or if you, depending on how you play, if you don't want to reinforce all of Workshop here, is actually this wall. This wall is one that's always forgotten, but in my experience in solo queue, not many people attack this wall, so it's not really necessary to reinforce. It's a powerful wall, so if you're an attacker, I would use this angle, but I don't see it too often in solo queue. So finally, we'll just go over basically what I'm trying to do with this series. So some of this stuff you might say is useless or you didn't find value in it. All I'm trying to do is give people a blueprint, rather, of what to do with strategies for solo queue. These are strategies that I do every game. Whenever I play border, I spawn peek heavily. And if I don't have success, I'm not going to keep dying to make my team lose the game. But reinforcing some of these key points. Like, too many times do I see some of these walls not being reinforced. Or reinforcing the hatches. So, in solo queue, you have to take what you think is the most valuable. So, if you're going to play upstairs, and you think that you want to stop the team from trying to have upstairs control, reinforce the hatches, and then play upstairs. If you want to sit on site, depending on where you want to play. So if you want to play right here, make sure you get this wall and maybe you get like this corner wall in case you have to rotate. This one right here. So in case you have to rotate right here, that you could still have good angles on everything. So there are strategies to give you ways to play and adapt it to your play style. This isn't a one-all be-all, but these strategies work. These runouts, these spawn peaks, these barbed wire locations, where to reinforce, these work. In 2019, in the most recent season, I got placed plat 3 off of 10. I think I only lost one game in my promos or my provisionals. These strategies work, so use them, get your ELO, and just win more games. So that's basically all I have for you today on Border. I was just going to go over these two sites. This video will be a little bit longer, but I'll have timestamps down below so you guys can skip around and come back to this video. Go ahead and let me know in the comments below what you think of this video, if you like this style, if you like how I go over my thought process for doing solo queue games, and let me know the next map or bomb sites that you want me to do. If you want me to do more border bomb sites, we can do that, or if you want me to do a totally different map in the most popular bomb sites from there, I can do that as well. Let me know if you found it helpful, like the video if you made it this far, and subscribe for more videos like this. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.